exhilarating sports talk coming up next on The Doug Stewart Show in about 2 minutes. Stay tuned. We're about to have some fun. That's right. Sports talk, guy talk, right here on The Doug Stewart Show. Show coming up in about a minute and a half. Hold on. The No Puppet Zone. That's right. No puppetry around here. The Doug Stewart Show coming up in about 1 minute. The realest, treeless, most unfiltered sports and guy talk show in America. The Doug Stewart Show, coming up in about 30 seconds. Yes!
Play this record as frequently as possible.
The Doug Stewart Show
is the best in the world as far as I'm concerned.
This is sports talk for the people. The Doug Stewart Show. It's like the tail wagging the dog. They create the narrative. Don't believe it. Don't fall for the banana in the tailpipe. Or are you not entertained?
This is sports talk with hot sauce.
Texas Pete hot sauce. The Doug Stewart Show.
Yeah!
A fantastic, freaky, funny Final Four Football Friday. It's a lot of alliteration right there, man. Yes, sir. I got a lot going on today on the Doug Stewart Show, man. April 1st, 2016. It's April Fool's, but don't you be a fool. Hey, Cassidy, bring that beat back for your boy one more time. Can you bring it back for your folk one more time? Bring it back! Oh, I'm feeling good, feeling great. How about you? Yes, sir. This is the Doug Stewart Show. April 1st, 2016. And oh boy, we got a lot of great things planned for you today, as we do every single day. Shouts out to all of the Stewies. I'll tell you what a Stewie is in a second. If you're new to the Doug Stewart Show, I really do appreciate it. Thank you for tuning in. What took you so long? We've been doing this show now for almost a year and a half. I mean, almost a year and a half we've been doing this show, man. And it's been going fantastic. I mean, it's been going splendidly, if that's even a word. I think it's a word. So it's been going fantastic, man. In any account, I don't care how you got here. You finally made it here. Trust me. We have the best, the most fun, the most unfiltered 2 hours in sports and guy talk in the world. We do. If you're new to the show, a couple things you need to do. You need to go to Spreaker.com. And once you find Spreaker.com, you get on Spreaker.com, then search The Doug Stewart Show. When you find it, hit the follow button and follow the show on Spreaker.com. And so whenever this show goes live or any other show goes live, you'll be alerted. That's very, very important. make sure you hit the follow button. And then you'll see a little chat bubble. You click on the chat bubble. You jump into that chat room. We have the best chat room in the world. I mean it. I'm not playing. I am not playing, man. I call it, and I get real serious when I say this sometimes, I call it the Fantasy Island of Sports and Guy Chat. I do. And its inhabitants, the people that are in there, the people that run that chat room, are my peoples. Those are my folk. I call those people the Stewies. Yes! My peoples! Yes, sir. And so what happens is they post their thoughts in there, sports and entertainment, whatever I'm talking about. I read a lot of that chat throughout the show. It makes this show totally interactive, the most interactive show in the world. I mean, seriously, I read a lot of the chat messages, and kind of the Stewies are kind of like my co-host. They're kind of like my wingmen. It's a very big part, a very integral part of the Doug Stewart Show. So shouts out and good morning to the Stewies. Become a Stewie. How about that? We got a packed show for you today. So, obviously, a fantastic, freaky, funny Final Four Football Friday. So, obviously, we're going to talk about the Final Four. The Cavs talking a little bit of smack. They come to Atlanta tonight. Colin Kaepernick booked in, locked in San Francisco. I'm going to tell you the percentage chances that the Warriors are going to pass the 95 Bulls 72-win season. So stay tuned for that. We got it broken down to science. And Matt Ryan, Atlanta Falcons quarterback, is in the news as well. Special day today as well. We're going to have on a little bit later the unofficial, and I mean he's unofficial, the unofficial comedian to the Two Live Stews, my man Special K, is going to call in today. And if you remember Special K from back in the day with the Two Live Stews, you know how he gets down. Real, real funny, funny cat. So stay tuned for my man Special K, the unofficial comedian to the Two Live Stews, coming in, dishing it with your boys today. As well as today is BPA Friday. Now, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. If you're new to the show, you're saying to yourself right now, BPA, what the hell is BPA? BPA stands for Boyle Peanuts Award. We actually renamed it the Stacy Dash Jason Whitlock Boyle Peanuts Award. It's a long story. It's a very long story on where we got the name from. Just ask somebody in the chat room. They'll tell you about it. Okay? It's a big misunderstanding, but that's neither here nor there. We have since titled the Buster of the Week in Sports and Entertainment the Jason Whitlock / Stacy Dash Boyle Penis winner. That's right. Boo to the Boyle Penis nominees. This week, last week, we had a huge selection to choose from as far as nominees. This week, we've only got two. And there might be a couple of more added to the list by the Stewies and the Doug Stewart Show chat group. But I'm not going to even list anybody else because nobody's going to beat one of these two guys. Your nominees for this week's Boyle Penis Award is D'Angelo Russell, the 19-year-old punk that taped his teammate and trapped him and put it out to the world. How dare you do that? How dare you, son? I don't care, you're 19 years old. You know better. You know better. I hate you. I hate you. I hope all the bad things in life happen to you. So D'Angelo Russell is nominated for a Boyle Penis Award. And the other nominee, man, is a very surprising entry. Because to America, he's holier than thou. But not in this case. The other nominee for this week's Stacy Dash Jason Whitlock Boyle Penis Award is Coach Krzyzewski. Coach K. Oh, lying, some of my Mitch. Coach K, talking about Dylan Brooks. He didn't tell Dylan Brooks that he was better than that in the little handshake line after the game. He didn't do that. He didn't do that. No, of course I didn't do that. He's a lying SOB. We got it on tape, man. We got you on tape, bruh. You did say it. And you lied. And then you came back with some bootleg. I mischaracterized. Whatever. What did he say? He said something stupid and trying to explain what he said. Man, just say you lied. You got caught and keep it moving, Jack. So, I don't know, man. Tough decision this week. And I mean, nobody wants the Boy Penis Award. Nobody. Because usually, what accompanies the Boy Penis Award is a couple of days, maybe even a couple of weeks of bad luck. A little bit of elbow of death sprinkled on your ass. And so those are your nominees. Go to the Doug Stewart Show Facebook group. There's a link posted there. You vote. You decide who's this week's Boy Penis Award winner. I talked about the chat room and how we have the best chat room in America. I didn't even tell you that you still can call in. You can call this show old school style. All right? 404-382-0338. You can also email me at doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Whatever's your pleasure, man. But once again, the easy way to be totally interactive is just to jump into the chat room on Spreaker.com. I'll read some of your chat starting up here in a couple of segments, so stay tuned for that. And that's how we're going to do it today. We get back from the break, man. Let's talk a little bit about the Final Four. Final Four kicks off tomorrow. When do they play the championship game? They usually play the championship game like a Tuesday night. I got to look at the calendar for that. But we'll talk about the Final Four tomorrow and some of the details about it. And I'll kind of get you caught up as well on the Doug Stewart Show Bracket Challenge, where right now the great Mocha Bella is winning. No, don't boo Mocha. There you go. That's right. If you're new to the Doug Stewart Show, we got a lady winning the bracket right now. She's not going to win the whole thing, though. We've already done the math. But she gave it her best. She gave it her best. So we'll catch you caught up on that as well. Once again, Special K, unofficial comedian to the Two Lives Two's coming on a little bit later. But we get back from the break. Let's talk a little bit about the Final Four and some of the storylines with the Final Four teams in this year's NCAA tournament. All right? Sports Talk with Hot Sauce. Texas Pete Hot Sauce. This is the Doug Stewart Show. We'll be back in 3 minutes.
Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BV Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices. So you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
National Debt Relief is one of the country's largest and most reputable debt settlement companies, made up of energetic individuals who are passionate about helping thousands of Americans with debt relief. Most importantly, we're all about helping our customers through a tough financial time in their lives with education and individual customer service. We're dedicated to helping individuals and families rid their lives of burdensome debt. Specializing in debt settlement, and they've also negotiated settlements for thousands of creditor and collection accounts. providing clients with both expertise and proven results. This means helping customers in time of hardship to get out of debt with the least possible cost. It can also mean conducting financial consultations, educating the customer, and recommending the appropriate solution. Core Services offer debt settlement as an alternative. I repeat, alternative to bankruptcy, credit counseling, and debt consolidation. National Debt Relief is your number one advocate group to help you reestablish financial stability as quickly as possible. So give us a call at 844-828-4975. Again, that's 844-828-4975, and work it out. I'm telling you, it's gonna be something. I'm
talking lights, camera, action. Okay, now welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Fantastic, freaky, funny Final Four Football Friday. Got a couple little football notes for you, man. You can give the call or give the show a call. The number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Man, we are doing some big things, some huge things in the works for the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. We do a lot of big things around here, not just interview you on the show, not just promoting you on social media or hosting or speaking at your event. We can do all of that. We can even play your music if you're a music artist on the show to our close to 11,000 followers. The big thing we are doing is broadcasting other shows on the network. Yes, sir. Like the Kicking It with Kesey show, the Grizz, the Barbershop Sports Talk podcast, John Fisher's Cooking with the Microwave featuring Vern from Jersey. I'm sorry, the number one Chiva rocker, Vern from Jersey. So we got a lot of things we're doing as far as trying to build this network, man. If you have a great show but you don't have a lot of listeners, we got listeners, okay? We can get your show heard from day one. We have close to 11,000 followers to the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. Over 500,000 listens to the network as well. Let's work together, man. I'm telling you, that's what a network is about. Email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. That's Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. I'll send you a rate sheet. We'll talk about the details and how it works. Shouts out, speaking of which, to the Barbershop Sports Talk podcast on yesterday, my man Trey and Maestro, as well as John Fisher and Vern from Jersey. I'm sorry, the number one chief rocker, Vern from Jersey, on their show yesterday, the Bottom to the Top show. Yes, sir. All right, Final Four this weekend. You've got the Villanova Wildcats taking on the Oklahoma Sooners. And the Syracuse Orange taking on the North Carolina Tar Heels. Let's look at Villanova and Oklahoma first. Villanova was blown out by Oklahoma in the first time that they played this year. The big thing in that game was Oklahoma made 14 three-pointers. So clearly Villanova is going to have to stress that. They're a much better defensive team than they were earlier this part in the year, earlier this year. So Jay Wright and his team, really a lot of people feel like, and I said it last week in talking about Villanova making it to the Final Four. I really, for some reason or another, schedule wise, I haven't seen a lot of Villanova, so I really don't know a lot about them. Out of the four teams remaining, I've got North Carolina winning the whole thing, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. I just think they have too much talent. But so Villanova in Oklahoma, they play tomorrow, 6:09 p.m. Eastern time is the tip off. In the Final Four, and then the second game, the final two teams, the last two teams in the NCAA tournament are the Syracuse Orangemen, or Orange, not Orangemen, that's not politically correct, sir. Syracuse Orange taking on the North Carolina Tar Heels. The Orange lost 5 of 6 games, including the ACC tournament opener, when the 68-team NCAA tournament field was announced a couple of weeks ago. The last double-digit seed, which Syracuse is a 10th seed, to make it to the Final Four was number 11 seed VCU 5 years ago in Houston. VCU lost to Butler, which lost to UConn in the title game. I'm sure you remember that. Kind of like one of the storylines that a lot of people aren't talking about, probably because they're very respected by the media, is Roy Williams and Jim Boeheim coaching the two teams that are meeting up in the Final Four and all the scandal that has surrounded these two programs over the last couple of years. You know, Jim Boeheim has already served a suspension for academic issues, and Roy Williams is on the clock. for academic issues as well with the North Carolina program. So very interesting that they match up in the Final Four this year. As I said a couple of seconds ago, man, watching North Carolina play, man, oh my gosh, and really in the tournament, because they weren't this good. They weren't playing this good of defense earlier in the year. But watching them play in the tournament for the last couple of weeks, it seems like somebody has hit a switch and they figured it out, okay? They have truly figured it out. They got tremendous players, man, on this squad. Cats that are going to play at the next level. The Jackson kid I absolutely love. So I'm taking North Carolina to win the whole thing. I mean, the whole thing. I don't see any reason why not. Once again, Villanova for me is the wild card because I haven't seen them a lot to really try to, you know, break them down. But right now, I think North Carolina is the cream of the crop. The Doug Stewart Show bracket challenge goes as follows. Man, don't hate, y'all. Congratulate. Damn, studio audience, they honorary as hell today. Right now, in first place in the Doug Stewart Show bracket challenge is Roma Lewis, but the streets know her as Mocha Bella. Damn. Hey, listen, I'm not saying it's a bad thing. Let me give you that disclaimer first before I even make the statement. We got to be the only sports talk show in America that's got a woman winning the damn bracket. Shut up! I'm just making a statement, a general observation. I love Mocha. And Mocha, actually, she's even talked about it, that this is her first year doing a bracket. It's her first year doing a bracket. That'll tell you how darn hit or miss it is. No, no, I didn't mean that like that. Shut up! Damn studio audience. So congratulations, Mocha, for being on top right now. But your time on top, like the great Biggie Smalls said, your time on top is short like leprechauns. Shut up! Small-ass leprechaun is her chances. Shut up. Shut up. Coming in at number two, tied for number two, is Kevin Bunning, my man Lacasmus Terrell. And actually, right now, Lacasmus and Kevin Bunning are tied all the way across the board. Lacasmus has a slight advantage as far as, you know, possible points in this thing. And I can't even see that bracket on what is exactly it's saying. I know what it is. He doesn't have any advantage at all. Basically, my man Lacasmus and Kevin Bunning have the exact same bracket. The possible points that they can get is 83. Right now, they have 147 possible, or they actually have 147 possible points that they can get. Right now, they have 83 points. The numbers that I saw are the actual score to the game, the combined points in the championship game. So they both have the same team winning, North Carolina. But right now, Lacasmus has 140 points as total score, and my man Kevin has 115 points total score. So those guys going to come down to the very end if North Carolina wins this thing. William Mack comes in at fourth, Kenny Caldwell at fifth, Al the Bandit at sixth, Altieri Bell at seven, and then at number eight, Mike Henry, number nine, Emmett Bean, number 10, Charles Mack, and coming in, rounding out number 17 is Doug Stewart. Shut up! What happened wasn't supposed to happen. So there you have it, man. Good luck to y'all on your brackets this weekend. We'll actually, I'll try to have the winner on, the inaugural winner of the Doug Stewart Show Bracket Challenge. I'll try to have the winner on the show, you know, to come on and tell us about their strategy and how they picked their teams or whatever. Did they throw darts or did they know what the hell they were doing? Did they just choose the team with the best color uniform, color scheme, or whatever? Shut up. I'm not saying Mocha did that. Shut up! Damn it! What? Don't get me a new damn studio audience in here, man. The number to the show is 404-382-0338. Shut up! You can be replaced! What's the matter with y'all today? The hell's the matter with these people today? From Grego, damn, Doug, you need to pick yourself to lose out so your magic will take you to the top. I'm reading chat in the chat room on Spreaker.com. From Cleotis. Cleotis says, Mocha. He says, Mocha, I was looking forward to hearing your interview maybe next year.
maybe next year. Maybe next year, but not this year. Maybe next year, Mocha, not this year.
And Cleotus didn't say all of that stuff at the end. I added that in. I added that in. From the colonizer, Texas Ty, he says, good, Clee, slowly but surely on episode 5 on season 2, I'm digging the second season. My man, Texas Ty, 10 years late, is finally watching The Wire. See, I even know what's going on with my peoples in their personal life. Yes, sir, with the Stewies. And so Texas Ty has talked about it in the Doug Shure Show chat group that he is for the first time watching The Wire. I have watched, and I don't watch a lot of series and movies a second time. I have watched The Wire, the complete season of The Wire, 3 full times. And each and every time I get an even better understanding and I pick up things that I missed the first go round or the second go round. Texas Ty, trust me, you're in season 2. And we talked about this on the Facebook group, but for people that aren't privy to that conversation. Season 2 is the slowest season out of the 5. I think it's 5 seasons. Season 2 is the slowest season out of the 5, okay? Doesn't mean it's bad. It's just the slowest. And what it's based on is the docs. Surely you understand this now. I'm not spoiling anything for you. It's based on the docs, the ports, and how the drugs come in, the bureaucracy and the political aspect of it, and all the behind-the-scenes stuff, city government, and how this thing is all bigger than, you know, just a couple of hood dudes and drugs and dope, all right? So that's what it's about. So I thought it was necessary to show that bigger picture. So I'm not like most people that kill and poo-poo on the second season of The Wire. I thought it was fine. I thought it was okay. But let me tell you, season 3, 4, and 5, when Marlo, when Snoop, when Chris show up, it's on and popping. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah, boy. Just remember that name, Marlo. Just remember that name, Shawty. Remember that name. Remember Chris and Snoop. Two of the most ruthless people in the history of television. Like, every character in The Wire was so phenomenal. Just about every character was so phenomenal. You know, they used a lot of the actors in The Wire. I think they used most of or all of the main characters, except for Idris Bell, Idris Elba. Who was Stringer Bell. I think a couple of the more known actors, after thinking about it, weren't from Baltimore. But a lot of the actors in The Wire are from Baltimore. What's his name? And you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Prop Joe. So Proposition Joe, who has, by the way, has passed on in real life. He died a couple of years ago. Prop Joe actually, like, was an accomplished thespian in the city of Baltimore, the real life Baltimore, and he actually had an acting school. So what Simon, the writer of The Wire, and a lot of the producers did is they went in and they used his actors in his film school, his acting school, as major characters, minor characters as well, on The Wire. So it really has that Baltimore authentic, you know, Baltimore is what they call Baltimore, has that real Baltimore attitude. Like Snoop, if you listen to the way Snoop talks, and I know cats from Baltimore. If you listen to the way Snoop talks, that's how cats from Baltimore sound, the street cats from Baltimore sound. Phenomenal show, man. You ain't seen nothing yet, Texas Ty. You ain't seen nothing yet. Yes, sir. All right, when we get back from the break, man, the Cavs, Kyrie Irving, talking a little bit of smack. The Cleveland Cavaliers come to town tonight. They're coming to the A. We'll talk about what they had to say last night on a big win for them. Sports Talk with Hot Sauce, Texas Pete Hot Sauce. This is the Doug Stewart Show. Don't go away. What is ID Life? Well, over the last 18 years, a group of scientists and doctors have been working on the development of a one-of-a-kind nutritional supplement program that takes all the guesswork out of what you need and delivers your truly personalized pharmaceutical-grade nutrition with your name on it directly to your door. through the integration of thousands of medical and scientific studies, answers you provide to the free assessment, and more than 5,470 algorithms that process the data, ID Nutrition recommends what you need, leaves out what you don't, and blocks things known to the system to have possible adverse effects based on the answers you provide. The result is a program that is revolutionizing the health and wellness industry. Welcome to ID Life. For more information, just go to thedougstewartshow.idlife.com. That's thedougstewartshow.idlife.com.
Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BV Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices. So you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Fantastic, freaky, funny, final four Friday. Yes, sir. R.I.P. B.I.G. Classic Mary J. Method Man. I swear to you, I'll be channeling my inner DJ, my inner FM DJ. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Once again, it is a fantastic, freaky, funny Final Four Friday. The funny comes up a little bit later, man, as we welcome onto the show the unofficial comedian to the Two Live Stew, Special K. Stay tuned for that. You know Special K be tripping. So, some things I'm going to ask Special K about. I'm going to get his thoughts on the whole Cat Williams controversy. Cat Williams. I'm also going to get his thoughts on D'Angelo Russell. And I'm also going to get Special K's thoughts on Sierra and Russell Wilson. Yeah, we bringing up that dead horse again. Yes, sir. So stay tuned for that. That's coming up a little bit later. In about 30 minutes, we've got, in about 45 minutes, we've got entertainment here on the Doug Stewart Show. Birthdays. Amber Rose is in the news. Jigga. About that paper. And, man, Ashley, that played Ashley on The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Tatiana Ali, she getting married to a buster. He might be all right. Why you call him a buster, Doug? I don't know. Why are you talking to yourself in third person like there's another person in the studio with you? So I'm going to tell you about Tatiana Ali and who she's getting married to a little bit later, all right? The number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. The Cleveland Cavaliers get a big win last night, 107-87, destroying the Brooklyn Nets. Big in the fact that they're still trying to keep pace and win the Eastern Conference, get some rest for some of the players on their team going into the playoffs. LeBron James had 24 points last night. Kevin Love had 19. And Kyrie Irving, man, he had 10 points as well. James scored 24 points once again to move into 12th place all times. And the Cleveland Cavaliers defeated the Brooklyn Nets 107-87 on Thursday night. He passed Dominique Wilkins once again for 12th place all times in scoring. Ball award to LeBron. LeBron is likely to pass the great Oscar Robertson, who scored 26,710 career points for 11th place on Friday night in Atlanta. That's probably going to happen. Now James has 26,689 career points. But once again, tonight he should pass the great Oscar Robertson. You know what? Let's reflect a little bit since LeBron, you know, reaches another milestone in his career. There's a lot of guys that have a lot of hype coming out of high school, coming out of college into the professional ranks. There's a lot of guys that have a lot of hype. I remember the hype surrounding LeBron James when he came out of high school, and it was massive. LeBron James has not only lived up to the hype, he has surpassed all of the hype. Ball award to that young man for his career. Ball award to that young man for his career. Now, there's also been some down times for LeBron James. We must bring that up. Just to give a little bit of balance to the conversation. There has been some down years. Losing several championships. Was he 2-for-4 in championships and winning rings? You know, the whole decision and going to Miami. A lot of people don't have a problem with that. I, like a lot of other people, do have a problem with that, though. But not anymore. I'm happy LeBron James back in Cleveland, so I'm a fan of LeBron James again. But then recently he came out and talked about putting together another super team. So I might be mad at him at some point down the road. But all in all, man, one of the greatest players to ever play in the NBA. Word is when they play here in Atlanta tonight at the Highlight Factory, he's going to try to talk to Dominique Wilkins and kind of, you know, get some well wishes from him, passing Neek as far as scoring all time. After the game tonight, the great T.I. is performing live at Phillips Arena. That's going to be good. If somebody got a couple extra tickets they can't use, email me. Right. Email me. If you go to Hawks games, if you're a regular, like if you have season tickets to the Atlanta Hawks, you may have noticed that you haven't seen me too much in the last 3 years. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Pinching pennies. Pinching pennies. You may have noticed you haven't seen me a lot during the last 3 years because that's a luxury I just can't do right now. I'm going to keep it real with you. I'm going to keep it real with you. So I used to probably go to, all right, so it's 82 games where you get 41 regular season games. I probably went to 20-plus games a year back when sugar was falling from the sky for the Two Live Stews. I went to over 20 games a year at the Highlight Factory, man. These days, not so much. But guess what? Gray skies are going to clear up. It can't stay like this forever. Truly, we are doing some huge news, syndication-wise, for the Doug Stewart Show is right around the corner, as well as broadcasting other shows. We're working on some things, trying to bring some other shows on the network. So the vision of the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network is looking good. And then, once again, I kind of like didn't want to talk about it too much, but we have a couple opportunities out there for the Doug Stewart Show to be heard nationally. Yeah, that's kind of all I want to say about it. I don't want to jinx it. I'm from the low country. You know, we believe in roots and all of that stuff. I'm sorry, I do. So we got a lot of stuff going on, man. Hopefully I'll be able to tell you about it in the next couple of weeks here. The number to the show is 404-382-0338. From Juan Cruz, my man Juan Cruz in New York City. New York City? Yeah. Juan Cruz says The Wire is one of the best shows written. I have to say that it was better than The Sopranos. Yeah, it took me a while to make the decision on whether I would put it over The Sopranos or not. And after seeing it a second time, you know, I just had to put it as the number one TV series I've ever seen in my life. And recently, The Sopranos got passed again by me with Breaking Bad, which is phenomenal to say the least, because Breaking Bad technically is network TV. They don't have all the liberties and all the leeway just to be, you know, all out and R-rated like they do on cable. So that should tell you how good Breaking Bad is. And that's coming from me, a staunch TV critic, okay? Breaking Bad is phenomenal. Walter White out this bitch. Yes, sir. Yeah, so Breaking Bad is number two. I think I gave the list a couple of weeks ago. So number one is The Wire. Number two is Breaking Bad. Number three is Sopranos. I can't even remember right now who I had at number four and number five. I can actually go back in my paperwork and look. I can find it. But yeah, man, it don't get no better than The Wire and Breaking Bad. I mean, it just doesn't, man. I mean, after you're done with The Wire, Texas Tie, and clearly you like my suggestions for your TV viewing pleasure, if you haven't seen Breaking Bad, that's what you need to do next. That's what you need to do next. Yes, sir. And if you've got Amazon Prime, I'm pretty sure Breaking Bad is on Amazon as well. You could probably get it for free. You know, all five or six seasons or whatever it was. Yes, sir. Classic TV. All right, when we get back from the break, I'm going to give you what the chances are, what the percentage chances are that the Golden State Warriors is going to bypass the 95 Chicago Bulls. I know y'all a bunch of bandwagon Chicago Bull fan, Michael Jordan fans in the studio audience. I know. But it's a RAP for that 72 wins. It's a wrap. It is. I'll tell you the exact numbers when we get back from the break, all right? Don't go away. Protect yourself at all times. The referee issues that reminder because it's important to a fighter's safety and success. Doug Stewart here to tell you about the team at Strickland Security and remind you that living in the Metro Atlanta area is sometimes like boxing. You've got to protect yourself at all times. There's nothing more important than ensuring the safety of your family and your home. And for business owners, protecting your business is critical because it's your livelihood. Strickland Security can satisfy all of your security needs. The staff at Strickland Security has a combined 55 years of experience protecting people and property, from alarm systems to uniform security guards and everything in between. Strickland Security has an affordable solution for you. To see a list of all the security services they offer, visit their website at strictlandsecurity.com or give them a call at 800-422-9075. Again, that's strictlandsecurity.com or give them a call at 800-422-9075. San Jose sports fans are winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com, America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play, so you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STU to play for free. That's STU for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STU, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STU. Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BV Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now.
That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you. This is your folk, Doug Stewart. Want to protect you and your family from life's unexpected mishaps? Then join 7. Join 7 is a prepaid legal company under the umbrella of the Protection Group. Join 7 is the only group benefit or motor club in the U.S. that offers auto reimbursement coverage, key replacement coverage, roadside assistance, gives you a current Medi-File, prescription savings, and fully encompassed prepaid legal benefits that include identity theft. They got you back. The average combined cost to purchase these benefits individually is over $850 a year. Join today and take advantage of all 7 for $17 a month. They've been around for over 20 years, so check them out by clicking on the banner link on my page, thedougstewartshow.com, or the app. Just go ahead and join 7. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. This is a fantastic, freaky, funny, and Final Four Football Friday. Thank you so much for joining your boy. I'm going to read more of your chat here in a second. We're going to get to that. Don't forget, Special K, the unofficial comedian to the Two Live Shoes, coming up a little bit later on today's show. So stay tuned for that. We still got the Boy Penis Awards that we got to give out later today as well. I need votes, though, man. Go to the Doug Stewart Show Facebook group and cast your vote for either Coach Krzyzewski for his lying ass or D'Angelo Russell for his snitching ass. Oh, boy, this is a tough choice this week. But the Golden State Warriors, man, experts, mathematicians have come up with some numbers as far as the Golden State Warriors' chances of passing the 95-96 Chicago Bulls. The Warriors have an 85.4% chance of breaking the Bulls' 95 record of 72 wins. Oh, and it gets even worse for you Chicago Bulls bandwagoners. Not only do they have an 85.4% chance of breaking the Bulls' record in 95, which is 72 wins, there's a 97% chance of at least tying it. Why are you booing? Shut up! That's right. ESPN stats and information, as well as some mathematicians, experts, based on the power index, put the chances of 73 or more wins at 80%. And that's the difference between the Spurs of overtaking the Warriors and BPI and play Golden State twice this season. Now, Golden State's next game is this Friday, which is tonight, against the Boston Celtics. And the Warriors are an 89.2% favorite. That's followed by home games. Listen to this. That's followed by home games against the Blazers. They've got a 90% chance of winning that. The Timberwolves, a 95% chance of winning that. What's up, Big Vince, right? And then they play the Spurs at home. And then they play the Spurs at home and a 65.7% chance of winning that. What kind of comes into play with a lot of people say, and the numbers say, could be a loss for them as they play the Spurs in San Antonio, who are, by the way, undefeated themselves at home. And they have a day of rest before they play Golden State in San Antonio. They've got a 32.6% chance of winning that game. But the thing about that is, we all know, is that Popovich probably won't even be playing his starters. It's a wrap. I'm taking all bets that they break this record. I'm taking all bets. I got 5,000 apples to bet on Golden State passing the 72-win Bull team from 95. I got 5,000 apples. I'm going to have to borrow it, so give me a day or two to get the money up. But I got 5,000 apples that I can borrow. If you don't think they're going to pass those boys. Let me read some of your chat, man. Thank you so much for all of your interactiveness. Hey, don't forget, today is, what is today? Scratching my temple. Today is offering day.
Yes, sir. I need you to dig deep down in your pockets and shoot your boy a 5-spot. We really would appreciate it.
Yeah, can you donate to the Doug Stewart Show? It's called the Triple F Campaign, $5 for the flavor. If you like the flavor of the Doug Stewart Show, if you like sports talk and guy talk with hot sauce, Texas Pete hot sauce, mind you, we ask that you donate $5 one time a month to the Doug Stewart Show. Go to thedougstewartshow.com, click on the donate button, donate $5 one time a month. Now, once again, today is offering time. Today is Friday. A lot of y'all getting paid. I'm not counting your money, but I know a lot of y'all getting paid. I used to get paid on Friday. So I know how it works, okay? You don't have to just donate $5. If you want to donate $50 or $500 or $5,000 on this quality radio program, you can do it. Don't feel like you need to be restricted. You don't. So if you some type of oil tycoon or Saudi Arabia princess or something like that, you got a couple hundred thousand just laying around, slide it to your boy. Shut up. Damn it. We really would appreciate anything, though. Thank you. If you donate $20 or more, we'll send you a T-shirt. That's real, though. That's true. From that ninja... That ninja says, I'm in season 4 of Breaking Bad. I don't know what's going to happen for me to put it above The Sopranos, but I'll take your word on it at this point. Okay, wait a minute. Let me stop for a second. Let me think about this. You are in season 4 of Breaking Bad. Okay, by season 4, it becomes phenomenal. Season 1, they tried to set the table in season 1, but it just got better every single year in Breaking Bad. Okay, once again, The Wire, fantastic season 1, a little down season 2, fantastic season 3, fantastic season 4, fantastic season 5. Breaking Bad was okay, it got better, it got stupendous, it got phenomenal. It just kept going up and up and up. You're in season 4? Yes, I believe so, yes. I believe season 4 is Face Off. That's all I'm going to tell you. I'm not going to tell you no more. I don't want to give nothing away. But season 4 is the face-off episode. I believe so for my Breaking Bad people out there. Y'all know what I'm talking about. That's right. Season 4, I'm 100% sure, is the face-off episode. Yes! I'm not telling you nothing. I'm not spoiling nothing, man. I'm not spoiling nothing, all right? Yeah. Yeah, just keep watching, my man, Ninja. Yeah, season 4 has some fireworks coming. From Clay Kanan Davis. I don't know about you guys, but I'm looking forward to watching this Jungle Book movie. Say what? Come on, man. Corporate brother. He says, Breaking Bad makes me want to leave my job and start cooking. Nah, bro, you don't cook like my man Walter White. You don't cook like Walter White. You gonna be making some trash product, bro. You gonna be out of business in a day or two. All right, so for people that don't know, the premise of Breaking Bad, I'm not telling you anything. I'm not spoiling anything. The premise of Breaking Bad is the main character has been diagnosed with cancer, and he's given like a year to live. He's a science teacher. Not just a science teacher, a brilliant science teacher. Science or... Chemistry teacher, I believe. And so he comes up with this whole plan to make methamphetamine. And I think it's based in Mexico. And evidently there's a big meth problem down there in real life. And so he concocts this whole plan to make and distribute meth to make money to leave to his family when he's gone. And that's it. That's the basis of the story. Phenomenal, man. The character's name is Walter White. Yeah. Yeah, Ninja, just keep watching. From P-Cola 3, The Wire equals number 1 all time, and it might even be number 2 as well. Is that good? I learn something new every time I watch an episode. I agree. I said the same thing earlier. I watched The Wire the second time around, and I understood it phenomenally or very good the first time around, but the second time around, I was like, oh, okay. Because the second time around, you kind of got an idea of how the characters connect. You know what's going to happen in the future, so... You know, things just a lot clearer when you've seen a series for the second time around. I mentioned a couple of weeks ago that Game of Thrones, which comes back here very soon here on HBO, that I got to be honest with you, man. You really got to sit down and just turn off everything. Turn off the computer, you know, shut your phone down, because the Game of Thrones has literally 30 different storylines going on. And they got hundreds of characters, man. It's very, very confusing. But any TV discerning person could understand that Game of Thrones is great TV. So I actually went back and watched that a second time as well. And once again, I just understood it so much better the second time around, man, that it was crazy. But you have to sit down and just pay attention. You feel like you in study hall or something, man, watching Game of Thrones. No lie. No lie. From P-Cola 3, he says, Power has a chance to be special if they keep it up. Possibly. I mean, they're only, would they just complete the second season? Second season was great, of Power. We'll see. I don't know. I never thought of Power in the regards of, like, The Wire, you know. Maybe. I mean, it's fantastic. It's very, very good. From Clay Kanan Davis, Doug, if you haven't seen the promos for The Jungle Book, you bugging. I've seen the promos, bruh. It's based on a fairy tale, a children's book. What? What am I missing? Did they make it adult? Did they give it an adult theme? Is it like one of the jungle girls and they're going to be the buck ass naked or something like that? What? What? What am I missing? What am I missing? I'm sorry. I'm not looking forward to the Jungle Book, bro. What I am looking forward, though, is the new Captain America, man. Civil War. I'm looking forward to that. They got your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man in it. Looking very forward to that. Yeah. I got a movie problem, man. I'm done with movies, though. Last movie I went to, last weekend, I went and saw that, what is it? What movie did I go see last weekend? And you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Oh, Batman versus Superman. Man, the ticket was $10.75. And then the most inflated product in the history of products, that damn popcorn, which they spent 60 cents on, probably. Not even that much. They spent 30 cents on. That and a small drink. And I hate when they get you with that small drink stuff. Like, I'm getting a small drink because I don't want to drink a lot of soda. You can get, like, a mini small size soda. You can get an extra, extra large for, like, 22 cents more. So, like, every time I go in the damn theater, for every time I go in the theater, I got in my mind, I'm not going to spend no money. You know, I ain't got it in the first place. So get you a small little soda. You don't need to be drinking soda anyway, but you got to have a soda. I got to have a cherry Coke with my popcorn. So get you a small soda. So, damn it, get to the cash register. I got it all in my mind. I'm getting a small soda. Sir, that small soda is $7.50. For 25 cents more, you can get a triple large. Man, go ahead and give me the triple large. Damn! Happens every time. At the end of the night, I spent $20 on a big-ass bag of popcorn and a big-ass soda that I'm not even going to drink. I mean, but for 20 cents more, I got to get the triple large, right? Damn, I hate the movies. Don't go away, the Doug Stewart Show. Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BV Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers,
actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices, so you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
National Debt Relief is one of the country's largest and most reputable debt settlement companies, made up of energetic individuals who are passionate about helping thousands of Americans with debt relief. Most importantly, we're all about helping our customers through a tough financial time in their lives with education and individual customer service. We're dedicated to helping individuals and families rid their lives of burdensome debt. Specializing in debt settlement, and they've also negotiated settlements for thousands of creditor and collection accounts. Providing clients with both expertise and proven results, this means helping customers in time of hardship to get out of debt with the least possible cost. It can also mean conducting financial consultations, educating the customer, and recommending the appropriate solution. Core Services offer debt settlement as an alternative. I repeat, alternative to bankruptcy, credit counseling, and debt consolidation. National Debt Relief is your number one advocate group to help you reestablish financial stability as quickly as possible. So give us a call at 844-828-4975. Again, that's 844-828-4975, and work it out.
Hour number two of the Doug Stewart Show, baby! Yes, sir! Where that scratch beat at? This is hour number two of the Doug Stewart Show. Thank you so much for joining your folk on this fantastic, freaky, funny Final Four Football Friday. It's a lot of alliteration for your ass. Shouts out to the Stewies. Happy Friday to you. Happy Friday to you. A lot of y'all are getting paid today, man. Congratulations on getting paid. You think you bad because you getting paid? You think you better than me because you getting a paycheck? Huh? Is that what this is all about? Are you here to laugh at Doug Stewart because y'all getting a paycheck? What am I, funny? What am I, ha-ha funny? You remember Tommy from Goodfellas? What do you mean? Am I funny? You mean ha-ha funny? And then Tommy went to killing the guy, man. Boo. Hey, welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Let's talk of Final Four. Getting your thoughts on Final Four, Cavs, talking smack. Kyrie Irving last night, I didn't even mention that when I talked about LeBron and the fact that he passed Dominique. Kyrie Irving says that he thinks that the Cleveland Cavaliers are the best team right now, or they're the team to beat in the playoffs is the way that he described it. And you know what? He's not too far off, to be honest with you. Now, I think right now Golden State, just like most people, think Golden State is a machine and that it's their championship to lose. But don't forget the Cleveland Cavaliers took the Golden State Warriors to 6 games last year in the finals without Kyrie Irving, without Kevin Love. So if they can figure some things out, man, they clearly have the talent. It's just been a chemistry issue for them, man. But we'll see. But Kyrie seems confident in their chances in the playoffs and winning an NBA championship. We will definitely keep our eyes on that. Let me read more of your chat. That's all I'm going to do is read chat this segment, man. From Uncle Mike. Uncle Mike says, you need to buy some cargo shorts and buy drinks at the store. You're exactly right, man. I feel pimped whenever I go into a movie theater, man, and they hornswoggle me into buying the big-ass popcorn and the big-ass drink. I eat all the popcorn. I never drink all the damn drink, but the damn deal is too good. I have to get it. Don't you hate that? Like, it's almost like a competition. It's almost like a game to me, man, when I go into movie theater. Like, in my mind, I'm telling myself, I'm giving myself a pep talk. Don't buy the big-ass popcorn. Don't buy the triple-large drink. Don't buy the big-ass popcorn. Don't buy the big-ass triple-ass drink. And then when I get to the counter, sure as my name ain't Sam, the chick rings at a little 16-year-old girl, inevitably. 16-year-old girl, you know, for 25% more, you can get 3x triple-large popcorn and 3x triple-large Coke. Damn, give it to me! You broke me down. You broke me down just that quick. You're right, man. I'm going to start taking my stuff in big-ass pockets and cargo pants and something like that. I'm not going to do that. From Corey. Corey says, like Bruce talking about Krispy Kreme. For only $2 more, you can get another dozen. Right! Exactly. Perfect example, Corey. What person in America would not get another dozen Krispy Kreme donuts for $2 more? You'd have to be the biggest dummy not to take that deal. Yeah. You'd have to be the biggest dummy not to take another dozen for $2 more. From the colonizer, Texas Tide, $15 for a drink and a popcorn ain't a good deal, no matter how you look at it. It's just not, man. But you know what it is? It's kind of like a routine for me. It's almost like I have an addiction. It's kind of like that's when you go to the movie. Like for me, a movie isn't the same without popcorn and a big ass soda. It's just not. It's something like if I'm not going to get the big ass popcorn and the big ass soda, I might as well just stay home and watch it on DVD. You know, get somebody to sell me the bootleg at the barbershop. Like the experience, the movie is all about the experience for me. Going into the theater, you know, walking into the theater. That's kind of like what they're selling. What they branded is the entire experience, the big screen, you know, obviously. And I keep telling myself, man, I'm going to stop letting these cats pimp me, man. I'm just going to go ahead and, you know, wait till it comes out on demand or wait till it comes out on iTunes or whatever. And I just continue to do it, man. It's just something about going to the movie theater, the whole experience, and watching the movie and in the theater, man. I got to fix that, though, because it's really bad because I really feel like they're pimping you. Like, we know good and well how much popcorn costs. We know how much it costs. Like, a big triple-large size of popcorn, the amount of kernels that they use in that. And then remember, they buy this stuff in bulk, not just for that particular theater that you're at. They buy it in bulk for like 50-11 theaters. So it's literally a 20,000% markup. It's probably a little cup of damn kernels for the popcorn, man. Probably cost you 3 cents at the end of the day on how much they spend for it. And we end up spending $11 for it? There's something wrong with that equation, man. And I know. You're a fool if you buy. I'm a fool, man. From Cleotis, and now the movies have recyclers or seats that move. You remember when the whole 3D thing happened and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show? You remember a couple of years ago, probably like 7-8 years ago, the 3D movies became very popular, and the IMAX movies became popular, and if you go to an IMAX theater and it's 3D, like that's just next world. And you remember when they first started, I don't know if they do it now because I do not go to 3D movies. I do not spend my money for that crap. They'll get me on popcorn, but they ain't gonna get me on no damn 3D. That's a wrap. But do you remember when the 3D phenomenon thing got real big like 7 or 8 years ago? You'd go to a 3D movie, they'd give you the glasses, or you actually paid extra for the glasses. You remember? Well, you didn't pay extra for the glasses. You paid extra for the movie. You paid extra for the movie, but then when you leave the theater, they ask you for the damn glasses back. I'd be like, you better get your hands off my damn face. I'm taking these glasses with me. Sir, can we have your glasses back? Are you crazy, man? Did you hear what I just say? You better get out of my face. I'm taking these damn glasses. I paid for these glasses. Oh, yeah, I got into a couple of riffs about that.
Sir, can we get the 3D glasses back from you? Oh, hell no, you can't get them back. It's the principle of the matter. It's the principle of the matter. Damn it, I'm taking these glasses with me. But, sir, you're not going to use 3D glasses at home. I don't care. Damn it, I'm going to take them to the beach. I'm not giving them back to you. I paid for these damn glasses. Yeah, I'm paying, you know, more money, but you want the glasses back? And in my mind, that's what I'm paying for, the glasses. You know? I don't care. No, you can't have the damn glasses back. But, sir, you won't use them. I don't care. Rail Scott, 3D is very overrated. I'm paying $7 more to see the same movie. GTFOH, a lot of them. That's right, GTFOH, a lot of them. I went to the AMC movie theater in Atlanta near the Cumberland Mall. I really love those seats they have. Yeah, and a lot of these movie theaters have stepped their game up where they have the bucket seats, the reclining seats. It's an experience, man. That's just what it is. It's an experience. And in Atlanta, and I haven't been there for many, many years. If you live in Atlanta, you know, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. In Buckhead, they had this movie theater, which was very small in relative terms, but it was called Buckhead Backlots. And what it was kind of like, it was a movie theater. Every movie and any big movie theater they had there, but it was kind of like set up, not like a restaurant, but like they had, you know, big reclining seats, and you had a table in the middle, and they actually served food there, which was real cool, and they served alcohol. So me and the wife used to go to Buckhead Backlots a lot back in the day, man, to check out a movie, because it was real cool. You got to eat, everybody nibbling on food, you get a six-pack of beer, me and the old lady sipping on some Heinekens. It was a real good experience. I haven't been there in many, many years. I don't know if they're even still in business. The great Buckhead Backlots from C-Mac Big Four. Doug, the movie tavern got the best deals, low ticket prices, and they serve hot food and cold beer. Okay, so where is this movie tavern at? Maybe you're talking about Buckhead Backlots. Maybe they changed their name to the movie tavern. From Cleotis, what happened to the dollar movies like we had growing up? Oh, yeah. Yeah. Back when we were growing up, man, everybody from the low country would tell you about the Fox Theater. The Fox Theater in Atlanta and Charleston, South Carolina was right off of Rivers Avenue. And they'd have these matinee movies for a dollar. And my mother would take us down there and drop us off. And that's where a lot of people got the funky beat down too by them Charleston dudes. Yes, sir. If you grew up in the low country and you went and saw your movies in Chucktown in Charleston, and you grew up during my era, you remember there was a lot of skirmishes out there, man. A lot of people got kicked to sleep out there at the Fox Theater. If a man Chucktown Frank is listening, he know what I'm talking about. From Easy Does It, Studio Movie Grill is better to me, and you can get the tickets on GroupMe for $6. Okay. You know what? I don't know why. We live so far out, man. We actually live way out in West Cobb for my Atlanta people to know the area, you know, Powder Springs area. And so we just go to the movie theaters that we have surrounding us. You know, we don't take that long drive. When I used to go to the Buckhead Backlots in Buckhead, that was when we lived closer to downtown. And us living all the way out there in the country, man, we just go to the movie theater in our area. Like, the closest movie theater for us is Hiram, Georgia. And then they've also got some off of Powder Springs Road. I guess you would call that Marietta. But yeah, I don't know. I know they got a huge movie theater. I've been one time for some event. They got a huge movie theater at Atlantic Station in downtown ATL. So yeah, man, I'm just a movie buff like that, man. All right. But at some point, I'm going to really get tired of these cats pimping me for this damn expensive-ass popcorn. Yeah. All right, when we get back from the break, man, birthdays, couple little entertainment stories. Jigga and Amber Rose got to get that money. They got to get that guap. And Ashley from the Fresh Prince married who? I'll tell you about that when we get back, man. Don't go away. This is the Doug Stewart Show.
San Jose sports fans are winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com, America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play, so you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STEW to play for free. That's STEW for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STEW, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STEW.
Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BV Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you.
This is your folk, Doug Stewart. Want to protect you and your family from life's unexpected mishaps? Then join 7. Join 7 is a prepaid legal company under the umbrella of the Protection Group. Join 7 is the only group benefit or motor club in the U.S. that offers auto reimbursement coverage, key replacement coverage, roadside assistance, gives you a current Medi-File, prescription savings, and fully encompassed prepaid legal benefits that include identity theft. They got you back. The average combined cost to purchase these benefits individually is over $850 a year. Join today and take advantage of all 7 for $17 a month. They've been around for over 20 years, so check them out by clicking on the banner link on my page, thedougstewartshow.com, or the app. Just go ahead and join 7.
If you're not stewing, what the hell are you doing? This is the Doug Stewart Show. Speaking of The Wire, Michael from The Wire.
Nothing's too much. Words that I live by. That's just how I do.
Do.
I'm young right now, but I won't be forever. So I'ma live it up like that's true. You might want to roll with me too. Said I don't mean to pray.
Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. I be getting my DJ, my FM DJ on. I don't care what y'all say. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show, man. The realest, truest, most unfiltered sports and guy talk show in America. All right, time for some birthdays, some entertainment news. Celebrating his 40th birthday today is actor David Oyelowo. Let me try to pronounce that one more time. David Oyelowo. That's it. David Oyelowo. He's the brother that played Dr. King in the movie. Happy birthday for him. Also celebrating. Wait a minute. That's it. Damn, a lot of famous people weren't born on April 1st. I guess that would have been too big of an issue with the whole Fool's Day, April Fool's Day. So that's it. The guy that played Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., David Oyelowo, turned 40 years old today. Happy birthday to him. Also, in entertainment news, man, Amber Rose just came out with a new app on iTunes and from the App Store. And the app made in its first day $2 million. And it's one of those emoji apps. There's one of those emoji apps where you create an emoji from different little, like, filters or whatever. And create faces or whatever. And they're selling it for $1.99. And on the very first day of this app, it made over $2 million. Amber Rose has already made $4 million from this app and has only been out in a couple of days. Lord have mercy, we living in a time, Fessa. We living in a time where in one day, a celebrity with no real discernible talent. This is what a celebrity is in 2016. You know, a reality star with really no discernible talent. The first day her app hits the app store, she makes over $2 million. So if she makes over $2 million, imagine how much the company made. Lord have mercy. Speaking of trying to get that money, Jigga Man, Jay-Z is suing his former owners or the former owners and execs of Tidal for $15 million, claiming that they grossly exaggerated their subscribers while luring him to purchase the service. Now, what Tidal is a music service where you can buy music, download music, and all of that type of stuff. And all of the big name rappers are kind of like involved with it and kind of like shareholders, owners in the company. It's a power move. It's a real big power move. According to reports, Jay-Z was told the streaming service had 540,000 subscribers when he bought his stake for $56 million. But Jay-Z now believes it was much lower. Lawyers said that subscriber numbers were a factor in setting the price. So he's suing, trying to get some money back. Jay-Z is a businessman, not a business man, or the other way around. He's not a businessman. He's a businessman. Yeah, the way that thing goes. And so Jay-Z trying to get that money back, man. And also, lastly, man, this is kind of a sad story to me. You remember the great Ashley from The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, and you're listening to The Doug Stewart Show? The great Tatiana Ali, who's fine as white wine. Yes, sir. Tatiana Ali is marrying Dr. Vaughn Raspberry. Now, I'm not judging no guy, man. You know, how he look or anything like that, man. But this guy looks like an absolute square. Damn! This guy looks like a clown. Where'd she find this dude at? Oh, I know where she found this dude at. She found the dude on a dating website. That's right. She actually found this guy, and they met on, what's the name of the website? And I had it in front of me, and you're listening to The Doug Stewart Show. On eHarmony. How you that fine? Pretty much well known. Has done TV for many, many years. She was doing TV when she was a small kid. She actually just had a TV show like on BET or TV1, one of them black networks a couple of years ago. How you on a dating website trying to find a man? And not only do you find a man on a dating website, you're about to get married to this dude? You deserve better. I want to say you deserve me, but I've been out of the game. Shut up! I'm a fan of that chick. I swear I am, and I guess it's just jealousy. I'm a fan of that chick. She's 39 years old. For some reason, I thought she was younger than that. And maybe when she was very, very young, I was kind of like in my early 20s or whatever. Obviously, based on that age, she's 39. I'm 46. So, yeah, I'm not that. I'm only 7 years older than her. Remember yesterday I was telling y'all, you listening to the Doug Stewart Show, I was telling y'all how I'm a fan of Keisha Cole. I'm a fan of Keisha Cole. Yes, Lord. Keisha Cole is number one. Number one is Kelly. We're talking about little, you know, entertainment crushes, you know, celebrity crushes. Number one is Kelly from Destiny's Child. Kelly Rowland. Number one is Kelly Rowland. Number two is the great Keisha Cole. Number three might be this chick right here, Tatiana Ali. Yes, sir. They all can get it. From the colonizer Texas Tide, she's about to be on eHarmony commercials. It does sound like a setup. Like, why would she divulge that information on a national platform like that? Yeah, it sounds like, they're about to set her up for a little commercial thing or whatever. From Cleotis, I know she is of legal age, but sounds perverted talking about her like that. It does. I know, because like when you talk about any child star, it sounds perverted, you know, like it's very weird for me to talk about, you know, Keisha Knight Pulliam marrying the Falcons linebacker, Ed Hartwell. And we talked about that a couple of weeks ago. Like, I can never look at Rudy in that manner. You know, she's Rudy. She's freaking Rudy. Even though she has grown up beautifully, she has grown up quite nice. Yeah. I have less of an issue talking about Tatiana Ali than I do about Rudy. Yeah. Yeah, she's 39 years old, bruh. Tatiana Ali is 39 years old. That'll tell you, but guess what, though? The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, that was a long time ago. I'm going to guess the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air probably debuted like 20 years ago. Think about that. Let me see if I can pull it up real quick here. Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. I keep saying I'm going to hire an assistant to come in studio with me. The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air debuted in 1990. Right. So 1990, that's 26 years ago. So add her age at the time to 26, that gives you 39 years old. Wow. Damn. I didn't realize even that the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air was that old of a show. 1990, the Fresh Prince first debuted. That's crazy, man. 404-382-0338. You can also email me at doug@thedougshewartshow.com. Coming up in the next segment, the unofficial comedian to the Two Live Stews, the great Special K, is going to join us. We're going to hear what he's dishing on. I'm going to ask him about Cat Williams, D'Angelo Russell, and Sierra and Russell Wilson. So stay tuned for that. From Choochie, Oats Just Taste Okay. If you ain't a gangbanger, Doug, if you ain't a gangbanger, Doug thinks you are a buster. Okay. From Old Man Cuddy. Old Man Cuddy says, Doug, don't say nothing bad about my girl Rudy, a.k.a. Keisha. Yeah, I can't say anything bad about her. She's fine as frog hairs. But she always gonna be little Rudy to me. Yes, sir. All right, don't go away. We get back from the break, man. Unofficial comedian. I mean, this guy isn't official. He's unofficial. The unofficial comedian to the Two Live Stews, my man Special K. Don't go away.
Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BV Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices. So you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
National Debt Relief is one of the country's largest and most reputable debt settlement companies, made up of energetic individuals who are passionate about helping thousands of Americans with debt relief.
Most importantly, we're all about helping our customers through a tough financial time in their lives with education and individual customer service. We're dedicated to helping individuals and families rid their lives of burdensome debt. Specializing in debt settlement, and they've also negotiated settlements for thousands of creditor and collection accounts. Providing clients with both expertise and proven results, this means helping customers in time of hardship to get out of debt with the least possible cost. It can also mean conducting financial consultations, educating the customer, and recommending the appropriate solution. Core Services offer debt settlement as an alternative. I repeat, alternative to bankruptcy, credit counseling, and debt consolidation. National Debt Relief is your number one advocate group to help you reestablish financial stability as quickly as possible. So give us a call at 844-828-4975. Again, that's 844-828-4975, and work it out.
The world's heavyweight champion of sports and guy talk radio, this is the Doug Stewart Show on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. April 1st, 2016. Don't be nobody's fool.
Yeah.
Do not be anybody's fool. Yeah. Hey, the number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. I talked about it all day long, man. Welcoming on to the Doug Stewart Show for the first time in a long time, man, my peoples, our folks, the unofficial comedian to the Two Live Stews, Special K joins us. K, what's up, brother?
Hey, man. What's happening, buddy?
Man, K, I ain't talked to you in a while, bro. How are you? What you been up to? What's going on with the Ricky Smiley Morning Show? How's my folk doing?
I know, man. It's been a minute, dog. It's been a minute. I'm still out here doing my thing, man. I'm grinding, you know, still doing the stand-up thing, of course.
Right.
You know, I'm traveling. I'm I'm doing the Royal Comedy Tour with some more at Earthquake. And then I got my own tour, Almost Famous, Always Funny. We hitting different cities, you know what I mean?
Okay.
That's the perfect way to describe me, man. Almost Famous, Always Funny.
Right.
Because I'm always funny, but I'm only almost famous. I tell my kids, say, Daddy, are you famous? I said, well, if you got to ask, then no, I'm not. But I'm not famous. I'm just fairly well known. That's pretty much where I'm at right now. Fairly well known.
So it's you, some more. Who else is on that tour?
On the Royal Comedy Tour is some more, Earthquake. Let's see, Don DC Curry, Arnez J.
Oh, that's some heavy hitters. That's some heavy hitters.
Gary Owen. I mean, it's a heavy hitting show, bro. They just added me to the mix this year with this particular run.
Uh-huh.
So we've done three shows already, and then we got some more things coming up.
Okay.
Going on into the summertime. You know what I mean? So like I'm in Baltimore this weekend doing my own thing. Next weekend actually I'm about to be in Mexico for a few days.
What?
But that's neither here nor there.
Wait a minute, I'm going to Mexico.
I'm on vacation, dog.
So you're going on vacation. You're not working in Mexico.
Yeah.
I'm about to say.
No, little family. No, I don't speak Mexican, bro.
I'm about to say, that's going to be a tough crowd.
Yeah, I don't speak Mexican. Ain't that a black thing to say, I don't speak Mexican, as if Mexican is a language?
No, bro, it's Spanish. It's Spanish, not Mexican.
I know, right. but you know, for black people stereotype, but we always imagine we get stereotyped. We call everybody Chinese. That is, I don't care. If you are any kind of Asian, to black people, you're Chinese. Man, I was at a beauty spot store, man, that Chinese lady was over. Dude, she's Korean. She's Filipino.
You know what?
None of them are from China.
I got to be honest, man. I know I'm guilty of that, bro. And I apologize.
I know you are, because you're a real N-word. I can't say it. Oh, I wish this was satellite. Oh, I wish this was satellite so I could say what I really want.
You can actually say it, bro. I mean, we try to filter a lot of that stuff around here, but you can actually go ahead and say the word if you want.
I ain't going to do it, man. We too close to Black History Month. Man. I'm still trying to be a role model for the young people out here.
We're talking to Special K, comedian to the Two Live Stews, unofficial comedian to the Two Live Stews. All right, so a couple of things have been out there, man, in the world of entertainment. I want to get your thoughts. I know y'all probably been killing it on the Ricky Smiley Morning Show. As a matter of fact, special shouts out to my man, Ricky Smiley. Cat Williams, bruh. Now, I know y'all comedians kind of got like a fraternity type thing, but Cat Williams been off the chain around this city in particular for the last couple of weeks, man. What's your thoughts?
Hey, man, let me tell you something, bruh. Cat Williams got in a fight with a seventh grader. That, if he don't do nothing else in his career, that might be his greatest move ever. How you 47 years old get into a fight with a seventh grader that you ain't related to in no way, shape, or form?
The kid was actually 17 years old. I think he failed like 5 or 6 times. But he was still
a seventh grader, technically. But to have any interaction, any physical interaction with a 17-year-old at 47, that's a pretty awesome achievement to pull off. I've made some horrible life choices, and I've made some horrible decisions at certain moments in my life, but I've never found myself physically fighting a teenager as a grown-ass man. Cat got some issues, man. Cat, you know Cat got issues with DMX is calling you saying, hey, bro, we need to talk. You need to settle down.
Right.
DMX actually called Cat Williams and said, hey, man, I'm going to need you to have an intervention. When DMX is calling you, telling you to get your shit.
You're right. You're exactly right.
Cat called Ayanna Van Zandt and she wouldn't answer. She said, no, I can't fix your life. She said, I can't. She said, I cannot fix your life. She said, you're not about to ruin my reputation. I can't fix your life.
All right. So I'm sure you heard about this story. With D'Angelo Russell for the Los Angeles Lakers, just dry. It wasn't even dry snitching, man. He put his teammate on videotape talking about his sexual exploits, even though bruh's about to get married. What's your thoughts on that?
Yeah, who does that?
Yeah.
Who does that? Like, D'Angelo, dude, like, what are you, a 12-year-old girl? Like, who sits there and records your teammate talking about, you know, chicks he done smashed and chicks you, like, his father should be ashamed. D'Angelo, I blame D'Angelo Russell's father for this. If his father didn't raise him, I blame his uncle for not spitting game to him and telling him how to be a real man. Because
right.
He got an uncle somewhere.
Right.
He got an OG somewhere in that neighborhood that should have sat him down a long time ago and gave him man law rules.
Right.
Like, dude, that's just something. That, I mean, that's almost as bad as going to the movies with your homeboy and sitting right next to him in an empty theater in the middle of the day. That's almost as bad as going in a bathroom with your homeboy and standing right next to him at the urinal.
Right!
It's such a violation. That's like going into a public restroom as a grown man and pulling your pants all the way down to your ankles to pee. I'm just saying. He committed. That is such a violation, dog. You can't do that.
You stop pulling your pants down to your ankles when you're 5, man.
That's like calling your homeboy wife and saying, oh, you know I saw your husband at Ruby Tuesday with some chick.
Right.
I thought it was you.
Yeah.
I mean, I thought it was you when I walked over there, but it wasn't you. I'm just saying, maybe it was his sister, but, oh, I don't think he had a sister. That's like, you can't get no worse than what he did, dog. What's wrong with you?
Finishing up with Special K, comedian, unofficial comedian to the 2 Hot Studios.
Can I say one more thing?
Okay, I kind of consider you as like a thinking comedian, man. What does that say about the youth of today, man? When you see these kids doing what D'Angelo Russell did, when you see these kids, you know, these rappers out here, Young Thug and whatever, what does that say about our youth of today?
Man, the youth of today, I think this whole generation, man, unfortunately, I think this generation is kind of lost because we done gone from, like, this. We like rap music, right? We grew up in the era of Sugar Hill Gang, Grandmaster Flash, you know, LL when he first started out, Kool Moe Dee, all that. Rappers had a message.
Right.
Rappers was talking to the community. They was talking to them streets, man.
Right.
They was from the streets, and they was talking to the streets.
Right.
You know, we had Nas talking about if I ruled the world, talking about, you know, real things. We had Tupac talking about changes, man, trying to change the way people think, the way people live.
Right.
Now we got Kevin Gates talking about I got 2 phones. You got a whole damn song about the fact that you got a Metro PCS and a Verizon. Why the hell you got 2 phones anyway?
Why
you got 2 phones?
right.
You got different ringtones on both phones, so now when your other phone ringing, you done forgot you put that ringtone, so you think it's somebody else's phone ringing.
Right.
So halftime, you don't even answer the other phone.
Right.
Got 2 phones because you're selling that much dope, you don't need 2 phones. You need a dope selling assistant. You need a partner. You need somebody else to help you sell all this dope.
Finishing up with Special K, comedian to the 2 Last Dudes here on the Stewart Media Entertainment Network. Okay, you making me laugh too much, bro. Last thing, and I'm going to let you go, man. I appreciate it. Last thing, Sierra and Russell Wilson. Our homegirl Sierra and Russell Wilson about to get married. Oh, it gets even worse. Russell Wilson is not going to ask Sierra to sign a prenup What does unofficial comedian to the Two Lies Two Special K got to say about that?
I got less of a problem with him not making her sign a prenup than I do with the fact that he been going with Sierra Fine Ass for all these, what, 2-3 years and ain't been doing nothing but hard grinding. I'm trying to figure that out. How you ain't hitting that? How you going to talk about you going to be celibate until marriage? But, bruh, she already got miles on the dog. That's like buying a vintage Corvette, but talking about you don't want to put it on the road, but it already got 100,000 miles on it. What the hell difference do it make if you drive it? And why do we know about this? Why we know? Why do I know? You ain't impressing me. That's like having the best video game in the neighborhood and bragging to everybody how you'll never play with it. You making us hate you. I ain't even a Seahawks fan no more. The hell wrong with you? You know, like, she, like, you just pulled her fresh off the shelf. Oh, I don't want to drive. Bruh. Sierra fine, man. Sierra is super duper. I met Sierra in person in the studio. Sierra's so fine, I just walked up to her and just apologized. I ain't even know why. You ever ran into a chick so fine, you apologized to her, you ain't even met her. I just said, I'm sorry. She said, but what? I said, I don't know, but I ain't know what else to say. I just apologized.
You just felt like you needed to apologize before you said anything.
That's the only thing that came to my mind. It was like, nigga, say you sorry. Just say you sorry. I don't even know what the hell I'm sorry for, but I'm sorry. I apologize. I meant it. I'm crying and everything.
Hey, K, man. Hey, square work, brother. I appreciate the time today, man. Special K,
hit me up.
Where can my listeners hear you at, man?
Man, you know y'all can hit me on, Ricky's Monday Morning Show. Damn. I almost forgot. I got a brand new talk show myself, man. K. Douglas Live at Noon. K. Douglas Live at Noon. Featuring my man Buck Wild. You can hear us on 1100 AM locally if you're in the ATL, but you can also hear us online at 1100entertainmentradio.com. And if you got iHeart and TuneIn Radio apps on your phone, just put in 1100 and our station pops right up. And you can check us out every Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday, 12 noon to 2 p.m. Check us out. We talk about a little bit of everything, man, and it's really good. So, you know, check us out, man. And follow me on Special K 913 on Instagram and Twitter, man. Find out where I'm going to be at, where I'm doing my thing at, all around the city and all that.
The unofficial comedian to the Two Lies Two, Special K. Appreciate it, bruh.
All right, dog.
All right, when we get back from the break, man, we'll wrap up today's show. This is the Doug Stewart Show. What is ID life? Well, over the last 18 years, a group of scientists and doctors have been working on the development of a one-of-a-kind nutritional supplement program that takes all the guesswork out of what you need and delivers your truly personalized pharmaceutical-grade nutrition with your name on it directly to your door. Through the integration of thousands of medical and scientific studies, answers you provide to the free assessment and more than 5,470 algorithms that process the data, ID Nutrition recommends what you need, leaves out what you don't, and blocks things known to the system to have possible adverse effects based on the answers you provide. The result is a program that is revolutionizing the health and wellness industry. Welcome to ID Life. For more information, just go to thedougstewartshow.idlife.com. That's thedougstewartshow.idlife.com. Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BV Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network. is you access the one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices, so you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there for all your sports and entertainment ticket needs. Call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
Penis tastes better boiled.
Ladies and gentlemen,
today we are going to begin our study of the male erection. We are adults. Now, I want everybody together to go ahead and say, penis, penis, penis.
Penis tastes better. Penis tastes better. Penis tastes better boiled.
Come on, y'all, say it.
No, man. Peanuts. I'm trying to say it as slow as I can. P-nuts. P-E-A-N-U-T-S. P-nuts. Y'all know what the hell I was saying.
Come on, y'all, say it.
It's that time of the week. We got to give out some boiled penis. That's right. One of the last things that you want to receive in the world of sports and entertainment is boiled penis. And your nominees for today, Coach Mike Krzyzewski. They call him Coach K. Red down Dylan Brooks, player for the Oregon Ducks. After losing to the Oregon Ducks, told him, you know, he's better than that, this, that, and the other. And he actually lied about it when somebody asked him about it. And he says, no, I didn't do that. That didn't happen. And they had his ass on tape. Your other nominee for the Boiled Penis Award for the week ending, what's today's date? April 2nd. Well, today is April 1st, obviously. April 1st, 2016, is D'Angelo Russell. I mean, you know what he did, man. I mean, there's nothing else really to say. We beat it to a pulp. We beat it just in the ground, what D'Angelo Russell did. It's really perplexed me, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, and this segment is brought to you by my good friends from Strickland Security. Strickland Security has the best alarm systems in the business. If you live in Metro Atlanta and you need a basic alarm system, or you need your alarm system fixed or anything like that, Strickland Security's got your back. Or they can give you an alarm system, hook you up with an alarm system that has like cameras and all of that stuff, you know, computer programs, apps along with it. They have a program for your homeowners association, for a community watch. My folks at Strickland Security are the bomb. Check them out online at StricklandSecurity.com. But back to D'Angelo Russell. Like, this is truly a head scratcher to me, man. And I talked about all of this stuff, but just to revisit it one more time. Like, there's no plausible explanation for what this young man did. I mean, there's none. There's nothing I can think of. Somebody sent me an email. I can't remember who it was, but somebody sent me an email and said that maybe D'Angelo Russell, you know, maybe he likes Swaggy P, as in sexually, and that he was jealous. Right, I don't know. Maybe he was jealous of, Iggy Azalea, and he wanted to break up their relationship because he actually likes Swaggy P. I mean, to be honest with you, that sounds hokey pokey, but that's just as good of a reason as I can think of. I can't think of anything else. I can't think of any reason, any scenario why someone you think is your friend, why you would think it was funny and it was cute to video record him talking about sexual exploits, supposedly during the time where he was still dating Iggy Azalea, knowing he was about to get married to this person and airing it out to the world. Like I can't imagine any scenario on how you thought that would be funny or that would come across as funny. None. I don't care that he's 19. I don't care. I don't care if he's 20 or whatever. It doesn't matter. There's nothing rational that I can come up with to say why he would do this. And for that, D'Angelo Russell overwhelmingly is this week's Boiled Penis Award winner. Voted by y'all, the Stewies. 77.78% of the vote, D'Angelo Russell beats Coach K. In any other time, Coach K would be the Boiled Penis Awards winner, no problem. But not today, not this week. D'Angelo Russell, you are this week's Stacey Dash / Jason Whitlock Boiled Penis Award winner. Wow. Wow. I don't know, man. I mean, I've seen a lot of bad things, especially doing this job, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, especially doing this job. Every once in a while, a huge story comes up, and I usually kind of gauge the stories and how big they are on how many days we talk about it. We really didn't talk about it a lot today, but today is the third day. Okay, today is Friday. We talked about this on Wednesday. We talked about it a little bit yesterday as well. And today is still relevant. It's still a big story. It's kind of still the biggest story out there. You know, over the years, there have been many big stories that have hit the press. And I knew it was going to be a big story. The Richie Incognito story. Richie Incognito and Jonathan Martin story down there in Miami with the whole bullying thing. I knew that was going to be a big thing. That was something that the country wanted to talk about. Oh my gosh, Mike Vick and Fighting Dogs, you know, obviously that was huge. There's been a lot of stories, man. When this story came out, I was like, yeah, this is really going to touch the pulse of the people and dudes in particular, because as much as you want to deny it, there is truly a thing called man laws. There is. And this dude violated it to the utmost, man. Just crazy, crazy. So there you have it. This week's Boiled Penis Award winner, D'Angelo Russell. From Clay, Kane, and Davis, he says D'Angelo wanted to smash Swaggy's girl. Really, dude? Really? But here's the thing about that. Maybe that's the case. And these dudes are very, very, very moist. They're very sensitive in 2016. Me and the great Special K just talked about that. It's a different type of young person today, man. If you listen to somebody... Okay, so maybe that's the case. Maybe he wants Iggy Azalea. She got a fat old ass. I don't think she that cute. I really don't think she that cute. Now, have you seen the pictures of her without makeup? Without makeup, she looked like she got hit in the face with a bag of nickels. I mean, she is not that cute. So maybe he did want to get with her. You don't, if you want to get with her and you videotape this dude, you would send it directly to her. That's not the case. Like, this hit social media. So I don't think that's the case even. From the colonizer, Texas Ty, he says the same thing. I think he was trying to get with Iggy, so he was trying to make her leave him. Yeah, but I don't think you would do it at that level. Nah, that doesn't make sense at all. Even if he was trying to get with Iggy Azalea, he would have to know the ramifications, because she would have to tell somebody, or she would have to tell Swaggy P, a.k.a. Nick Young, she would have to tell him that she has this videotape, and where the videotape was made, clearly, it was made by D'Angelo Russell. So in turn, Nick Young would still tell the world that Swaggy P took a video of him, you know, even though it didn't get out to the masses in public. He would have told the world that his boy videotaped him at some point talking this trash and gave it to his girl. That still doesn't make sense. Still doesn't make sense. From Clay, Kane, and Davis again. He says, Trussell was caught lying on tape about the tattoo hate. From the colonizer, Texas Tie, Iggy's about 20 miles of muddy road. Yeah, she's not cute now. Now, I'm going to be honest with you. when she first came out in that video, what was it, Sassy? Whatever the video was. You know, she had her makeup done right. They accentuated her booty the right way. Her little lyrics, they kind of were cute. So it took a dude like me to take notice. Yeah. But I've seen a lot of pictures of her in the last year and a half or so where, I mean, she aight. Like, I don't know if Nick Young has seen her without makeup. Like, you ever went out with a chick, and I've had this happen plenty of times, you ever went out with a chick where they wore makeup even when you went to bed with them or whatever? You knew that type of chick that wore makeup all the time. Like, they didn't want you to see them without makeup. And then, you know, that next morning when they, you know, they went and they washed their face off and you saw them coming out of the bathroom and you saw their real face, you're like, damn, oh, man. Hey, fellas, young fellas out there listening to the Doug Stewart Show, take your girl to the beach. Take her to the pool. Take her swimming. Okay? Before you get too deep into it, take your girl swimming. Yes, sir. Let me grab a call. Caller, thanks for calling the Doug Stewart Show. What's your name? Where you calling from? What do you want to talk about?
So, what's that?
What's up? Who's this?
Steve in Montreal, sir.
I'm sorry, sir. Can you repeat that one more time? You weren't clear just now.
T from Huntsville, sir.
T from Huntsville. What up, T?
Man, you know, enjoying the show as always, man. I know you got to get out of here, but I think the problem with D'Angelo Russell, man, is he didn't learn that life lesson. I said about something said when you talked about, you know, how your boy did you in college.
Yeah.
When I was in seventh grade, man, that we had a dance after school. The way the school was built, you got little tunnels. You can get loose in the tunnels, you know. I don't have to go any further. So, you know, had a little fun or whatever. And, you know, some cats asked me about it the next day. And like a dummy, I talked about it.
Right.
These dudes got with the chick that night, put her on three-way, and called me.
Oh, and, the dreaded, like, three-way call.
Yeah, the three-way call. And like a dummy, I elaborated once again. And then I heard her voice. It wasn't really angry, but more like sad and disappointed. Say, you talk too much. And then hung up.
Yeah.
And they started laughing hysterically.
Yeah.
And, you know, from that day forward, I never did that again. I never made that mistake. And really the problem with it was I felt like an ass. But the end of the thing is, you know what I'm saying, he hasn't learned that lesson, and he hasn't had a man jack him up for bitch-assiness type behavior.
Right.
And that's what's wrong, man. Appreciate the show, man. I'm gone.
I appreciate the call, T. Yeah, that's – I never had the whole three-way setup thing happen to me, but I got a very good friend. This was when we were in middle school, same type of middle school kid stuff. He was messing with this chick, and I can't remember the exact details, but basically he talked bad about the person and her and his boys put him on a three-way, and they had the chick on the line listening to him diss her. You know, the girl thought that he had liked her a lot, and this is like one of the most popular girls at our school at the time. This is back in like 1978. And so this girl was very popular, but she was skinny. And they got this other dude on the phone that she liked, and they were supposedly a thing. This is back in like sixth, seventh grade. And the dudes put her on a three-way, and they were talking about her, and he was responding like, nah, I don't want to mess with that chick. She too damn skinny. And she got big eyes, this, that, and the other. And then at the end of the call, she just spoke up like, man, I didn't know you felt like that. If that's how you felt about me, you should have just let me know. And she hung up. Broke her damn heart. That chick ain't been the same since. That was 40 years ago. But guess what? Like I said yesterday, when that story got around, you know, when that story got around, you knew not to put your business out there like that. You know? And the dudes that did that to him, my boy never forgave them. And everybody called them suckers. That ain't funny. That ain't funny. Now, it was the sixth grade, so it's not as big as D'Angelo Russell and Iggy Azalea. It was back in 1977. We all probably forgot about it in a day or so. But it was still impactful. It was a life lesson, man. The bad thing about D'Angelo Russell, man, he's learning his life lesson on a worldwide stage. He ain't never gonna live this down. I'm sorry. Hey, thank you so much for joining me today on the Doug Stewart Show. Thank you. Shouts out to my man Waterhead Walter, Dwayne Vassan, Gerald Oliveri, engineers to the show. Shouts out to my man Pink Gator and Beans and Cornbread on the production of this hot-ass track. Yes, sir. And a special thank you to the Stewies, man. Without you, there would be no me. Thank you. Y'all be careful on them streets this weekend. We'll be back on Monday. Same Doug Stewart time. Same Doug Stewart channel. Yeah.